This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about some transformations of rational functions. So let's start out with the basic function, f of x equals 1 over x. I've sketched a graph of this. It's got a vertical asymptote along the y-axis, or x equals 0, and a horizontal asymptote along the x-axis, or y equals 0. Now, if we take this basic fraction, 1 over x, and we add something to it, some constant, what we're going to do is raise the whole graph up if the constant is positive, or lower the whole graph down if the constant is negative. So for instance, if I make this 1 over x plus 2, what that's going to do is raise the entire graph up 2 units. The horizontal asymptote would become y equals 2. If I want to shift it to the left or the right, what I can do is add or subtract something from the x in the denominator. So if I turn this 1 over x into 1 over x, let's say, plus 3, then what I'm going to do is shift the entire graph over 3 units to the left. In other words, if I add a positive number to the x, I'm going to shift the graph over that many units to the left. If I add a negative number to the x, we would shift the graph over that many units to the right. So in this example, let's do both of those transformations. I've got this 1 over x plus 3 plus 2. The horizontal asymptote is raised up 2 units to y equals 2. The vertical asymptote is shifted over 3 units to the left to x equals negative 3. And then the basic curve of the graph, those two curves, are just going to shift 3 units to the left and 2 units up. So I'll have something like this. If I want to flip the graph over, I could take the numerator and make it negative. So if I make this negative 1 over x plus 3 plus 2, what I'm going to do is take those two curves and flip them across that horizontal asymptote. So the graph is going to start out curving up towards the vertical asymptote. And then after it passes the vertical asymptote, it'll start towards the bottom of the graph and work its way up and over to the right towards the horizontal asymptote. We're going to have basically the same kind of transformations if we have the graph of 1 over x squared. So let's take a look at that. The basic graph for 1 over x squared, once again, is going to have a vertical asymptote along the x-axis, along the y-axis, and a horizontal asymptote along the x-axis. Both of the curves will move towards y equals positive infinity. Something like this. And we can do the same transformations. If I want to shift this up or down, I'll add some constant after the whole fraction. So I could maybe shift this down 3 units by making it 1 over x squared minus 3. That would just lower everything by 3 units. I could shift it to the right by adding some negative number after it. Like maybe, let's just do a negative 1. So I'm going to have x minus 1, put that whole thing in parentheses, and then square it. And that's going to shift the vertical asymptote and everything else with the graph 1 unit over to the right. So let's take a look at that. I've got the vertical asymptote shifted to x equals 1. I've got the horizontal asymptote shifted down to y equals negative 3. And the graph is still going to curve upwards on both sides of that vertical asymptote, going along the vertical asymptote towards y equals positive infinity. And once again, if I change the sign in the numerator, that would keep the asymptotes the same, but the graph would then curve downwards towards negative infinity. Okay, so for both of these functions, 1 over x and 1 over x squared, we're basically seeing the same thing happen. We can move the entire function up or down, the entire graph, by adding a positive constant at the end of it after the fraction if we want to move it up. We can move it down by adding a negative constant. We can shift it over to the right by adding a negative constant after the x and before we square it. We could shift it to the left by moving a positive constant, a positive number, after the x and before we square it. And we can flip it across the horizontal asymptote by changing the sign in the numerator. Okay? Hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.